Salam students, today we will be doing the revision of the writing skills, that is about formal letter. I request you all to keep a book and a pen ready so that you could note down all the important points that are being mentioned for your exams. Now, what is a letter? A letter is one's person's written message to another pertaining to some matter of concern. So you write a letter to another person to convey some kind of a information or message. It could be to another person or it could be to some organization or institution in charge. Now you have learnt about two different kinds of letters that are existing. That is, you have formal letters and informal letters. Formal letters basically deals with issues that are official in nature. That is, you write letters to someone who is holding a position or to some kind of an organization, to an institution. And an informal letter is more personal in nature. That is, you write to your friends, you write to your relatives, you write to your parents. So this becomes little informal. So today we will be focusing more on the formal letter, as you have that for your exam. So we'll just revise formal letter. Now in formal letter you have different types. What are the different types of letters that you could get which are formal in nature? Like, you write to the editor. That is, editor of a newspaper, editor of a magazine, relating to some kind of an issue or some kind of a complaint that you can make which needs to be published in the newspaper. You could also write a letter to the principal of the school wherein you are asking for some kind of leave permission or some other permission, some applications which you address the principal. You could also write a letter to the police informing him about some thefts in your locality. Also, you have order letters where you place some orders, maybe of some kind of instruments, your books, some kind of sports equipments, lot of things where you place an order to a particular company who will then be delivering that to you. They will supply that particular material to you. So you address that in the order letter. You also have complaint letters wherein there may be some kind of a defect, some kind of a possibility of a defective piece that has come in from your order placed. So you write a complaint to that particular company, making them aware of the details of the defect. And also maybe asking them to supply you a replacement of that particular thing. You can also write an inquiry letter wherein you are inquiring about certain things, getting some information about maybe a course, maybe other details about certain equipments which you require for your institution or for yourself. All these comes under the formal letter. You can also write an application letter, maybe a job application to some company, asking them about the details for a job. All these comes under the application letter. Or any kind of business letters are all coming under the formal letter, the type coming under the formal letter. So you could get any of these letters in your exams also. So all these types comes under the formal letter. Now when you write a formal letter, you need to keep in mind certain things, certain guidelines which needs to be strictly followed. First of all, it should be written in an appropriate format. The format is prescribed. There is an appropriate format that is available. You need to use that. Your letter has to be written in that particular format only. So students, learn the format really well. We'll be doing the details about what should be included in your format in the next slides. Use simple words which are easily understood. So the letter that you write, the words that you use must be very simple. Do not use complicated and confusing words which is not easily understood. So your letter has to be very simple. Also, do not use short forms. So anything that you write must be in a full form. Don't use abbreviations or short forms in your letter. It must be precise and to the point. So whatever subject you're handling, whatever is the subject of your letter, that thing must be focused on. It has to be to the point. You have to be very precise. Do not write too much, too lengthy letters. It has to be very precise. Only relevant information should be mentioned. So whatever is needed, what is necessary, that particular information needs to be given in your letter. You need to mention only those information that are really important. Avoid spelling and grammatical errors. Of course, when you write a letter, you need to be very well versed with your spellings. There shouldn't be any grammatical errors that you make. Also, the tone of the letter must be very polite and respectful. You shouldn't be very rude, or you should not use harsh words. Even if it is a complaint letter, you have to be really polite and respectful, because you are addressing it to some person who is at a higher position of that particular company. So you need to be really polite in the words that you use in your letter. The subject line of the letter is very important. So what subject you write, what is the main subject of your letter, has to be very appropriate. It is very important, because this is what attracts the reader. The person who is reading your letter immediately understands what the subject of this particular letter is. So this has to be very important, very apt and appropriate. It must be well presented. The overall presentation of your letter must be very neat. It should be neatly presented without any errors, without any cuts or cancellations. It has to be very appropriate and presented very well. So now students, let's look at the format of the letter. What are the things that are included in the letter? What elements are involved in the letter? First of all, you have the sender's address. So first you need to mention the sender's address, that is the person who is actually writing the letter. So that particular person's address needs to be given in the sender's address. After this, you will be leaving a line and then writing the date. The date also has to be given in a prescribed format. We will do this in the later slides. After you write the date, you have to again leave a line and write the receiver's address. Receiver's address is to whom you are actually addressing the letter. Who is going to actually read your letter? So that particular person's address you need to mention. After this, you leave a line again and write the subject. That is, what is your letter dealing with? What is the main subject of your letter? After that, again, you leave a line and write the salutation. Salutation is, you are addressing the person, sir, madam, or maybe dear sir or dear madam accordingly. Then you leave a line and start with the body of the letter. That is the main letter, the main content wherein you are actually discussing about the problem that is in the subject. What is the actual problem that you're writing the letter, or what is the subject of your letter? This has to be left aligned. You have to write the body of the letter very precisely. You leave a line again and then you give a complimentary close or a subscription. What does this mean? You write yours faithfully, yours sincerely, accordingly. You give a complimentary close. After this, you write the sender's name. Leaving a line, you write the sender's name. That is, here you give the name of the person who is actually writing the letter. So, in the first place, you write only the address. You will be writing the name of the person at the end. Also, if there is a designation given, the position given in a letter, you will mention even that. We will deal with this in detail, taking into account one example in our next slides. So, this is basically the format that you have to follow. You need to understand this format very thoroughly, what comes after what. So, note that you need to leave a line after each of the elements that comes in the format of the letter. So, students, I hope you have understood what the elements are in the format, how the format goes about. Now, let's take one example question and then analyze this step by step. So, the question here is, you are Ankit Sharma, a resident of 40 Green Avenue, Mulund, Mumbai 509. Write a letter to the in charge of the electricity department complaining about the frequent power breakdown happening in the area. So, this kind of a question you may get. So, understand the question very properly. What are the things you need to remember here? So, let's now discuss this question in detail. First, we'll take up the sender's address here. So, as I told you, you will not write the name of the person sending here. So the person sending the letter is Ankit Sharma. But here you need to write only the sender's address. So, here you have 40 Green Avenue, Mulund, Mumbai 509. So, this has to be written in the top left side of your sheet. Do not use any punctuations, comma or full stop. As you can see how the address is written, there are no commas or full stops used at the end of every line. So, you are not using any punctuations. Do not mention the name of the sender here. So, it is dealing only with the sender's address. So, you are writing only the address which comes in the top left side. So, next, now after leaving a line, you will write the date. Now, as you can see, the date mentioned here is 20 March 2020. There are no commas used out here. This is the correct format. On the other side, you can see I have crossed. All these formats are the wrong formats. You are not supposed to write in this format. Like 20th March, the TH should not be mentioned. You can't write it in short forms, that is March, which is mentioned as MAR, or in any other format which is wrong. So, date has to be written in the correct format. You also don't have to mention that word date there. You're only writing the date, that is 20 March 2020. After that, you leave a line again, you write the receiver's address. Again, this goes in the left-hand side of your sheet. What is the receiver's address? What we had checked up in the question, the in charge, which is the designation, electricity department, Mumbai. So, you're writing a letter to the in charge of the electricity department. Now, again, as you can see, there are no punctuations, there are no commas or full stops at the end of each line. So, you have to write it in a very simple way without any punctuations. Now, here the designation is mentioned, that is the in charge, so you need to write it. After that, again you leave a line, and now you'll be writing the subject. This is a very important part of your letter. According to the question, the subject here is frequent power breakdowns. You are writing it in only this brief way, that is, it should be very short and precise. So your letter is dealing with frequent power breakdowns. So you don't have to give a long subject matter. You have to just make it very short. It must convey the matter for which the letter is being written by you. So just looking at the subject, the person who is reading your letter must be clear with what you're trying to inform him. So the subject must be clear and apt to grab the reader's attention. So it has to be very attractive for that manner, so that it can immediately be understood by the person reading your letter. After that, you again leave a line, and then you have the salutation. Now the correct form of salutation needs to be used. So there are two formats given. You can use any one of them which is right. Like you can say, just mention as sir, madam. Again, you are not using any comma after writing sir or madam. Or you could write dear sir or dear madam. This is the correct form for the salutations that you would give in your letter. Next important part of your letter is the body of the letter. This is the main part of your letter. Now the body of the letter has to be divided into three paragraphs. You have to write your letter in three paragraphs. So your first one would be introduction. Second paragraph would be the details about the subject which is in question. And the third paragraph is your conclusion. Don't write one single paragraph as your body. You have to divide your letter into three paragraphs. It must be very precise and to the point. Don't write long letters. It has to be very short, because it's a formal letter and you're just giving an information to the person who is in charge or person who is going to read it. So it has to be very precise and to the point, explaining what your subject is. So your body has to be divided into three paragraphs. Now, according to the question given to you, let's see how you can divide these three paragraphs. So the first paragraph, as I said, is an introduction. You will begin from the left side margin only. So here the introduction could be, this is to bring to your kind notice about the frequent power breakdowns in our area. In this burning heat, it is very difficult to do without power supply. The frequency of breakdowns have increased comparatively. So just you give a brief introduction about your problem. In the second paragraph now, you write the details of what is actually your problems, what are the things you are facing. Now, because of the power breakdowns, the examinees, small children, elderly persons and the invalids are suffering the most. The pumps do not work and the overhead tanks remain almost empty. The inverters also get tripped. The people at the area distribution point do not give any satisfactory reply. They are rude and indifferent in nature. Most of the time they choose to avoid and not respond to the queries put forth from our side. So your second paragraph would give the details about the subjects. This is all that you have to mention. Don't elaborate too much, because then the person reading it gets bored and maybe he wouldn't address your problem also. So the first paragraph is the introduction. The second is the subject details. Again, in between these, you need to leave a line. Finally, you have the third paragraph, which is the conclusion. Conclusion is where you just give a request, maybe what you expect from their side. So you could just mention You are requested to take remedial action and save us from this man-made inconvenience. Kindly ensure continuous power supply to make things bearable in this summer heat. So this is just an expectation, a request that you make to the in charge of the electricity department. So your conclusion must be only this brief. Don't again exceed the limits. So your body has to be divided into three paragraphs, leaving a line in between. So I hope you have understood what you need to do. After this comes the complimentary clause or subscription. So here, after you complete the body, you give a thanking you and then give a complimentary clause. Do not use apostrophe marks in yours. Yours has to be without an apostrophe mark. So you could write yours truly, yours faithfully, yours sincerely. Again, there is no comma at the end of the line. As you can see, the correct format given. So you could use any of these, but do not use the apostrophe or the comma. There should be no punctuations used. And finally, you have the sender's name, signature and designation. So you write the sender's name. Who was the sender out here in this question? Ankit Sharma. And what is the designation given? He's a resident of Green Avenue. So you just have to mention this much. So you write the sender's name and below that you write the resident or the designation of the person in question. So if the name is mentioned, you will write that name. However, if the name is not given in your question, you will just write XYZ. You are not disclosing your identity anywhere in the letter. So just have to mention XYZ. If designation is mentioned, you will write the designation. If it is not, you need not write it. You just have to write the name. Followed students, I hope you have understood the format, each and every element of the format, what needs to be done, how it has to be written. So understand this, go through this for your exams also. You could get questions based on format. Now let's just see one more example. It's write a letter to Messrs. HMT Corporation, Chandigarh, complaining that the wristwatch you recently bought from them does not function properly and ask for a replacement. You are Deepti Deepak Gupta, 450 Sector 20, Chandigarh. So now looking at this letter, we can understand that the sender of this letter is Deepti or Deepak Gupta. So you have to write the sender's address that is given. You have the receiver's address also. Date you will be mentioning, the date you are going to write that particular letter. Considering the format, the receiver is Messrs. HMT Corporation, Chandigarh. This is what you will write in the receiver's address, again without any punctuation marks. What would be the subject? Defect in the wristwatch purchased. This is all you will write. Don't exceed the words. You have to be very brief and precise in your subject. Then comes the salutation. You could say sir, just sir, without a comma, and then divide your body into three paragraphs. So in the first one, you'll just give a brief introduction as to when you purchased it. Then go on to writing what is the problem with the watch. And finally, at the concluding paragraph, you would say that you would ask for the replacement maybe, and what are the things you could help with dealing with the defect in the watch. And finally, you give the complimentary clause and then the sender's name out there. So you'll just write here, there is no designation of the sender given, so you will only mention the name of the sender. So students, I hope you have understood what a formal letter is, how it needs to be written, what are the things in the format you need to remember, how the format is, what is the flow of the letter, the elements involved in the letter.